Hi to all. In this video, we are going to see about design of rotor of three-phase induction machines. Before going to design, types of rotor we should know. One is squirrel cage rotor, another is phase wound rotor. Squirrel cage rotor, why it is called squirrel cage? Because that design itself, that rotor just like a squirrel cage. And in the case of phase wound or slip ring rotor, what we doing? Just like how we are designing the stator, the same way we are going to design rotor also. Okay. Main difference is the torque will be very less in case of squirrel cage, but it's robust. Life will be very huge, very high. But in the case of slip ring rotor, we can add the external resistance, but torque also very high and life will be less when compared with squirrel cage rotor. Now we see design of rotor. There are two types of rotor constructions. One is the squirrel cage rotor and the other is the slip ring rotor. Okay, most of the induction motors are squirrel cage type because construction wise it's the easiest one. Okay, they have the advantage of rugged and simple in construction and comparatively cheaper. Okay, however, they have the disadvantage of lower starting torque. I already told you, squirrel cage having low starting torque. Okay, in this type, the rotor consists of bars of copper, not like a conductors. Here, we are using bars, copper bar or aluminum bar. Okay, copper or aluminum accommodated in rotor slots. In case of slip ring induction motors, the rotor complex is construction. Okay, slip ring, if you go for slip ring, the rotor construction itself complex and costlier with the advantage that have a better starting torque. This type of rotor consists of star connector, distributed three-phase winding, how we connect the stator, the same way we connecting here also. Between stator and rotor is the air gap, which is very critical part. Air gap is very important one. Okay, it plays a major role when you go for design a machine. The performance parameters of the motors, likely magnetizing current, power factor and overload capacity and cooling and noise, are affected by length of the air gap. Hence, length of the air gap is selected considering the advantage and disadvantage. Let's see what are the advantage if you go for high value of air gap and what are the disadvantage when high value of air gap between stator and rotor. Okay, when we go for high value of air gap, the advantages are increased overload capacity. We can increase the load. Okay, increased cooling because air gap will be more. So, cooling also more. Reduced unbalanced magnetic pull. That also will be reduced. Reduced in tooth pulsation. That one. And reduced noise. These are the five major advantages when we go for high value of air gap between stator and rotor. When you come for a disadvantage of high value of air gap, increasing magnetizing current, reduced power factor. These are the two major drawbacks when you go for high value of air gap. Effect of magnetizing current and its effect on the power factor can be understood from the phasor diagram shown in figure. Okay, magnetizing current and magnetizing current and effect of power factor. Okay, these are the phasor diagram for effect of magnetizing current and power factor. Okay, here Vs is the supply voltage, ER is the generator voltage in rotor. Okay, both the cases, and IR is the current, and pi m is the flux. Okay, like that angle between the things. Magnetizing current and the power factor being very important parameters in designing the parameters performance of induction motors. The induction motors are designed for optimum value of air gap or minimum air gap possible. Hence, it is designing the length of the air gap following empirical formula is employed. Air gap length LG is equal to 0.2 plus 2 square root of DL mm. Here we can see the diagrams of the squirrel cage rotor and slip ring rotor. Okay, in squirrel cage, it's just like a board. Okay, in slip ring, what they will do? They are using slip rings, and that just like how we connecting in stator, the same way that three terminals R, Y, B were taken out and connected to slip ring. That's why the another name of phase wound rotor is slip ring rotors. Okay, number of slots, proper number of rotor slots and proper number of stator slots, it's very important one. Okay, the chosen of number of slots is very important one, otherwise undesirable effects will be found at the starting of the motor. Cogging and crawling are the two phenomena which are observed due to wrong combination of number of rotor and stator slots. In addition, induction motors may be developed unpredictable hooks and crusts if we go for improper number of slots between stator and rotor. Okay, because lots of noise. Let us discuss cogging and crawling phenomena in induction motors. Crawling, the rotating magnetic field produced in the air gap of the will be usually non sinusoidal and generally containing odd harmonics of the third and fifth and seventh. Third harmonic flux will produce the three times the magnetic poles compared to that fundamental harmonic. Similarly, the fifth and seventh will produce poles 5 and 7 times the fundamental respectively. The presence of harmonics in the flux wave affects the torque speed characteristics. The figure 16, this one, from this figure, okay, below shows the effect of 7th harmonics on the torque speed characteristics of 3 phase induction motor. The motor with presence of 7th harmonic is a tendency to run the motor at 1/7 of its normal speed. So, the 7th harmonic will produce a dip in torque speed characteristics at 1/7 of its normal speed. I show the figure. Okay, this is a normal one, and this will be the 7th harmonic. This will try to pull the speed of the motor by 1/7. Okay, cogging. In some cases where number of rotor slots are not proper in relation to number of stator slots. Okay, the machine refuses to run and remains stationary. Under such conditions, there will be a blocking tendency between the rotor and stator. Okay, cogging is nothing but locking of rotor and stator. Such a phenomena is called cogging. Okay, hence, in order to avoid such bad effects, a proper number of rotor slots are to be selected in relation to number of stator slots. In addition, rotor slots will be skewed by one slot pitch to minimize the tendency of cogging. Here the word skew is nothing but a small angle will be placed in rotors. Okay, that is called skewed. Effect of skewing will slightly increase the rotor resistance and increase the starting torque. However, this will increase the leakage reactance, will answer. Reduce the starting current and power factor. Selection of number of rotor slots. We have some formulas. Based on that, we should select the number of rotor and stator slots. To avoid cogging and crawling, to avoid these two things, we should not, that's SS, stator slot should not be equal to rotor slot, and SS should not be not equal to plus 3. Plus or minus 3P, the values of SS and SR plus or 3P. Okay, to avoid synchronous hooks, cusps in torque speed characteristics, it should not be equal to plus or minus P and plus or minus 2P, plus or minus 5P. These things, if you avoid, the synchronous hook will not be occur. The noise operation, to avoid this one, SS and SR should not be plus or 1, plus or minus 2, and plus or minus P. Plus or minus 1 and plus or minus plus or minus 2. Okay, thank you.